Gia, an Instagram famous PR brand mainly for celebrities or models. That's a bit on the pricey side, but today I found a solution so that you can make I Am Gia your own at home by yourself for under $10. So let's get into it. Okay, so for the fabric, I'll give you three options. Number one, sweatshirt material. Great for the sweatshirts. I'll link a really nice cheaper option down below. Okay, number two, stretchy spandex material. I'll link a couple cheap options down below. Spandex fabrics are good for the top part, but if you're making shorts that are a little bit looser, they'll probably end up showing your privates. So if you want to be a little extra fun and fresh, you can also mix and match, but you do you, man. Three, this is the fabric I used for this pair of shorts. It's called a flannelette. You can use sort of like linen or bedsheet type fabrics. Honestly, probably your cheapest option. I'll link a couple down below. Or you could thrift a bedsheet from your local thrift store and you have a little thrift flip situation. And now with that in mind, let's go move on to the pattern. Okay, so for my sweatshirts pattern, you can pause here to take a look at all the pieces you're going to need.
I basically took an old pair of shorts that fit me good and I traced the pattern. I'll link a video in the description of how to trace your own pattern from an old pair of shorts or pants. And don't trace the waistband because we're going to be making our own, and I'll show you how. For your waistband and your pants, you're going to need waistband elastic first of all. I got mine off Amazon, I'll link it down in the description. But basically, you're going to take the length at the top of your pattern times it by 4, which is the circumference of the whole entire waist. Add a couple inches of seam allowance on both ends. Now you're going to take your waistband elastic, measure the width, times it by 2, add a couple quarters inches of seam allowance on both ends. That is your length and width of your waistband elastic. And let's cut pockets. Now for your side pockets, just trace your hand in sort of like a mitt shape thing. You can make it bigger or smaller as you want. And I always love to add butt pockets.
And to do that, you just draw a square, add an inch at the top, add your seam allowance, curve the edges, cut out the square, fold it in half, and then cut out your curves, and boom, cute pocket.
Okay, so for the I Am Gia top, this is where things start to get a little more complicated, but still, it's pretty easy to piece together.
Easy peasy lemon squeezy!
And pause here for all the pieces you're going to need.
Okay, so let's talk straps first. For the two longer straps, you're going to make them 1.5 inches by anywhere from 40 to 50 inches, depends on how long you like your straps. And for the Ickle Baby middle strap, you're going to make it around 3.5 inches by 5 inches. Okay, on to the tip pieces now.
First, you're going to find the center of your chest and measure the length of one boob and also the width. Hopefully this really bad drawing will show you how important it is to add an inch onto each one of your measurements because we're going to be scrunching up the shirt later on. Then add the length of your tits vertically onto the paper and the width horizontally, add your seam allowance, cut it out, and then boom, you have your nice tip piece. Next, mark down the measurements of your tip pieces, subtract a quarter inch for the straps, and then make it around 5 inches wide. And since we have to hem all the sides later on, add an extra 1/2 inch to everywhere except the top. Cut that baby out, and now you have a completed pattern.
And now we have all our pieces ready to go. Let's get to the sewing part.
First off, after cutting out all my pieces, I sew down the sides of each half, like so.
Okay, I just got a package in the mail. Oh my god. This is bikini fabric. This is gonna be amazing.
I'm gonna make so many bikinis from this.
Butt pocket time. So first I sewed the top down and notched the corners to get a nice rounded edge when I pinned and sewed it. Then all that was left to do was trim off the excess, and like Beyonce said, to the left, I slapped down that pocket on the left ass cheek of the pant. And for the side pockets, I placed them about 2 inches down from the waistband and sewed them right sides together. And when you're done, they should kind of resemble little baby duck wings. And then I notched the sides of each pocket before putting the whole thing together, like IKEA furniture, except you're pinning and sewing down the sides. Then you're going to want to sew down the crotch because crotchless pants have little to no use outside the bedroom.
Nice.
You can step back to admire your handiwork and then flip her inside out. Okay, waistband time. First, you're going to want to sew your band together into one full circle, fold it in half, and pin it to your waistband of your pants. Then attach the waistband, but remember to leave a 1 inch opening for your elastic to go through. Then take your waistband elastic and measure it around your hips. It helps to try the pants on first sometimes. Then pop out your handy dandy safety pin, insert the elastic through both ends, like a little Eiffel Tower situation. Oi. Then sew both sides of the elastic together, tuck it back into the waistband, close up the hole, and then top stitch the waistband a couple times, if you want. I find it looks better. And lastly, I'm just hemming the bottoms so that they can survive the washing machine. And boom, baby, you can slap the ass to your newly made pair of shorts.
Wake up, Mr. West!
So first I cut out all my pieces, and if you're using sweatshirt or flannelette material, the straps won't turn out, so this is how you gotta make your straps instead. Just sew down the sides and you're good to go. Just a reminder to eat breakfast and maybe give your dog a bite too.
Next up, I hem the bottom pieces by folding the fabric over twice, not thrice. And I did the bottoms first, and then the sides. And then I attached them to one side of the tip piece, right sides together, and just straight stitch down. Then I sandwiched everything together like a nice old egg McMuffin, and sewed all around, but marked an opening for the top so you can turn the whole thing out. And remember, just don't sew it shut. And then I cut holes on all ends just wide enough for the straps to go through and trimmed off the excess while I was at it. Then just straight stitch down on each side of the holes you just made for security reasons, and then you can turn that baby inside out. And yes, even though it looks like a really gross old 2000s tube top, don't worry, it'll get better from here. Just sew channels down the sides big enough for your straps to go through, and then you can take your loop turner or safety pin and just loop your straps through nice and tightly. And to close up the hole at the top, just tuck in your edges and top stitch. And here's where the magic happens, baby. Take your tiny piece of fabric, fold it in half right side together, sew down the sides, and then flip it inside out. Then you're just going to want to scrunch up your shirt and wrap your fabric around it. And then just stitch them together so two sides can become one.
Okay, the last step, here we go. You snip a part off that you just sewed, and then you just sort of just turn it inside out so that the sewed part doesn't show.
And there you have it, your IMG-inspired set for cheap. Now let's move on to the reveal.
Hey, we got a good thing. Don't know if I'ma see you again.